Hi, welcome to Fearless Friday Power Up Tips. I'm Dranitsaris, and today I'm going to be giving you some tips on how to recognize the difference between caretaking employees or enabling them and actually just demonstrating care and concern for them. Caretaking employees has become increasingly common in these times when the boundary between the personal, what is acceptable in the workplace to bring to work and what to talk to your manager or boss about, or what we as leaders invite our employees to talk about, and how we've interpreted the messaging in this past decade in particular, that we need to humanize leadership, we need to be caring, and that if we're not caring and demonstrating concern to our employees, then if they decide to leave and take another job, it's our fault. And that's a burden that we all place on ourselves, because we're being told that we need to demonstrate more caring without really knowing, well, what does that look like? You know, does it mean that we're just asking people, how was their weekend? Or, you know, and they're telling us about how overworked or how overwhelmed they feel with their life and the amount of stress and the instability in their lives, that we need to demonstrate caring by talking to them and listening to them for long periods of time. And that's where it gets really blurred for leaders, because they think that they're demonstrating caring by doing that, by giving themselves, by trying to problem solve employees' personal lives, but really that is an overstepping of the boundary between a caring leader and a caretaking leader. Of course we care about our employees, but we're not there to provide personal counseling and advice. When we're caretaking, we're actually letting employees complain about things that are going on, even in the workplace, without thinking that we need to lead them around to resolve the issues that are causing the complaints. And similar to that is the expression of excessive empathy, showing employees that we hear them and that we're on their side without getting to the issue, or sometimes even without listening to somebody else's side of the story and what's going on. Another way we fall into caretaking employees is that we don't necessarily give them work, or we overcompensate by withholding work from an employee because we know how stressed they are. These are all ways that we fall into that trap of being a caretaker, because being caring, it doesn't necessarily mean that we have to spend a whole lot of time, but that we're non-judgmental about what's going on with an employee. We demonstrate our interest in getting to the issue while empathizing, and a desire to really understand what's going on with them, and affirming that this indeed sounds like they're having a difficult time, but also asking questions about how do you think your personal situation is going to impact their life, and what might you need as an accommodation because of our timelines going forward. That we hold that boundary by saying, you know, well, I would love to be able to spend more time with you, I don't have the skills, or really I don't have the amount of time your situation requires, but I can direct you toward a resource where you can get more help and more support. It's being involved with them without doing it for them, without enabling them or making them believe that you are there for more than being their manager or being their leader. You are not their friend, but you can be friendly. You are not their caretaker, but you can demonstrate caring. So what one needs to do, and some tips to go from caretaker to caring leader, is acknowledge the emotions but focus on the issue, and be conscious of your own desire to want to make their problem go away by jumping in and rescuing them or counseling them. Refer them to somebody who is qualified to actually help them with their issue. And value your own time, that you don't always have time as a manager or leader to really dig deep into what's going on with someone, why they feel the way they do, or to problem solve the issues that they're having around personal management and self-management. And communicate that to your employees by holding the boundary, as in my previous example. And you can follow up, demonstrate caring by following up with them, asking, you know, how are you doing with that issue that you brought to me, the other day? You know, have you followed through with getting some more support through the resources I've given you? And demonstrating caring in that way. You want to not invite more than you're prepared to really take on and really handle as a manager or leader. It's not your job. Be really clear on it. The difference between caring and caretaking can make all of the difference to you, yourself, getting your work done. And if you're an employee listening to this, it's recognizing that you're not going to your boss for them to really caretake you, to be a counselor to you, but you just want to share with them what's going on with you and how it might impact your work. Being communicating those things clearly as an employee allows your manager to provide the support that you need while boundarying it and perhaps directing you to the resources that you need. Until next time, that's all for today. Try to really work with creating boundaries, because it helps us, it helps our employees, and it helps our leaders really be present to the issue and not overly focus on emotions in the workplace. So until next time, bye for now.